You know, I was gonna come up here and apologize about how I didn't have a video up, like, last week or whenever you're seeing this, but then I realized that I do have a video, I just didn't edit it, and I was gonna come and, like, say that I didn't have any books because I didn't read any books, but I actually did read a book and I just didn't edit the video, so it's all my fault. I'm sorry, I'm sick, but maybe you can guess what the book is. It's a pretty hefty book, so maybe you guys are excited for it. I don't know, but I'm nearing the end. I'm like 200, 300 pages away from the end, and I'm about to get it done. It's gonna get a couple of views. I hope you guys enjoy it. It's a lot of fantasy mega style stuff, so maybe it's gonna be great. But obviously, you guys came here for the movies, not for the books. What am I thinking? Come on, phase one, Marvel, let's go. I don't know the song. That's Star Wars. Okay, so I don't know any Marvel music, so I can't actually do that. But first season of Marvel, I got all the notes right over there on the table. I'm about to review every single movie in that entire phase one, which is about 8, I think. In phase one, we've got 3 to 6 movies. We've got 6 movies overall. I'm about to review all of them in this one video. Real quick, I'm gonna go over them, like, maybe 1 minute each. I'm gonna give them a rating, each of them, go through the strengths and weaknesses. And in the next video about Marvel, you're gonna see phase 2, and then phase 3, and then eventually maybe phase 4. So that might be coming up soon, but who knows, I'll still be doing the brand new reviews, but originally I was obviously intending to do a review for every single Marvel movie, but, I really don't want to go through like 30 videos doing stuff that really not that many people watch, so I'm just gonna go ahead and condense all of them into 1 or 3 videos, just so that we can get through them really quickly. Also, I did get one video done, which is the Hulk video, and also one of the Iron Man videos. Yeah, the first Iron Man, Hulk, the second Iron Man as well. I got all those done, 2 of them edited. I put one of them up on my channel, another one went up on a different channel. I'm not gonna go ahead and take it down. The link to that is gonna be in the description down below, but I am gonna go ahead and, like, re-review that right here, just in case, you know, nobody cares about that, which you probably don't. I'm just gonna quickly do that now. Hurry up, let's get to the video, come on. We start phase one off with an Iron Man 1, the brilliant movie. It's a great movie just to start off the entire thing. And obviously it's one of the most iconic, being one of the most, the first one being having the most iconic superhero from the franchise, having the original, most simplistic tale, starting from the very beginning of the Avengers. And it's a great movie overall, okay? So it's fine, in my opinion. It works out for all the things that it is. It has a strong character, it has a strong, just a general sense of this is what the universe is gonna be, a great, decent world building so far, and it starts it off with a decent punch. Obviously, it's not as great as the recent Marvel movies. People often put this as one of their top slots of all time, but I will not do that, because this movie is meh at best. It's a solid movie, but it just doesn't compete with anything else that they've put out. I really hated the overall plot structure of the entire thing, because originally there was a supervillain at the beginning, or just a villain, and that was pulled out through the entire movie. And so we've got this villain that we thought we had finished off right at the beginning, that's continuing to, like, just infiltrate the entire movie, and I don't care about that anymore. Also, the villain that was kind of brought in later on is also really bad. I didn't like either of them. They didn't really have good development. They didn't have a strong personality. They didn't really have a reason to be evil. It was just meh, I'm gonna be evil. So I just didn't like the plot and stuff, but it's a totally cool movie. I say it's a great world building movie, because obviously it begins the world, and it begins it off fine. We learn everything that we need to learn, and we learn it pretty well. This movie gets a 2 out of 5, because it's meh, it's fine, I don't really care. Second up, we have the Hulk movie, which I've also reviewed on another channel, of course, link in the description. Iron Man also, I've reviewed that, that's gonna be on one of my videos, you'll find it. But the Hulk is a very important movie, because it's the least important movie. Nobody's watched this movie. And by nobody, I mean, like, nobody has watched this, because it's not the same actor as Bruce, but it's still in the same Marvel Cinematic Universe, because Tony Stark does come back as the same actor. We've got the same people, it is part of the MCU. And so people just generally don't watch it. And I think that's a fair reason that, you know, people discount this, because nobody really counts this in anything. It's a fair movie, it's fine, but it really does not hold up to the Marvel standard. It's not funny, it does have a tone, but the tone is really, really dark and grim, and it was just too grim for me to really attach onto anything. I was kind of looking for an excuse to just look away, look at my phone, stuff like that while I was watching the movie, because it just got a little bit too intense, if not like a tension way at the, you know, climax, but just generally it was kind of like, oh, why am I, this is kind of weird. I don't really want to be in this atmosphere. I want to get out. And so I really don't like the atmosphere of this. I can appreciate what they were going for, and I think they got what they were going for, but just people don't like what they're going for. 2 out of 5, let's go to the next one. Iron Man 2. Now this one, I think, got a lot better. People usually don't like this one. They say it's way too cluttered that you can't really appreciate much of the villains or the plot points. And I can see that for sure. There's way too much going on in this movie. But I think that they pull it off far better than other people say. It's definitely underdeveloped, of course, but if it had been properly developed, that would have been incredible. Here it was half developed. It was underdeveloped, but it was well enough developed that all these interesting ideas, they were all really interesting ideas, don't get me wrong, there's just too many of them. And when you brought these interesting ideas together, they weren't fully developed, but they were developed enough that I personally got to care about them. So I actually like this movie. 3 out of 5, let's go on. Next up, we have Thor, and I don't know the rest of the name of this movie, but it is the first Thor movie. I did not like this movie whatsoever. This is one of my least favorite movies. I think that it was a horrible, really badly executed concept. And the concept, I guess, was kind of cool because, you know, you have this god coming down. I really kind of liked Thor's arc because it was a very interesting in concept, that arc itself, which is that he would be banished or something like that, and he would be really, you know, he would not be worthy to hold the hammer, and that's really interesting. I loved the fact that Thor was being stripped from his greatest power, and that was so cool. I loved that part, but everything else, putting it together, was really bad. It was all over the place. It was really boring. I didn't care about this Mexico, New Mexico area. I don't know where they were. It was really boring area. I didn't care about the other characters. Jane, I think her name was, she was so boring. I completely couldn't stand her. And the ending battle was really, really anticlimactic because you've got this massive, powerful dude, and then just Thor grabs his hammer, which is kind of lame, you know? I was thinking, why would you put a machine up to this guy? And that's not a fair match. It was just really badly made. This is a 1-star in my book. Captain America, The First Avengers. Now, this is where we get to a decent movie. One of my favorites of the first thing. One of my favorites in this entire phase. It's gotta be my second or third favorite movie in this, apart from Iron Man 2, in my opinion, but this would probably be a really, really solid movie just because of the beginning hour. That part was just fun, just seeing the origin story of this guy, Steve Rogers, was just so interesting, seeing this guy's character grow up. I think it was very corny, of course, but apart from the corny stuff, like the grenade scene, obviously, people love that scene. I don't know why. It's really, really corny. It doesn't do a good explanation of his character, but that's not as great to me. To me, the favorite part would be when he was taking a drink later on with the professor dude. I think that was a funny scene. Did really well for his character and everybody's character. The grenade scene was meh. It developed the character of Captain Rogers really well. So I absolutely loved that part of it, the character building part, and I absolutely loved the love interest in this. That was interesting. That's probably the best love interest. It was extremely interesting just because of how it was left off at the end. I loved how it was finished off and how it was such a heartbreaking portion of that movie. You know, it's usually supposed to be like a decent love story. You know, you get together, that's kind of the entire thing. This one is the opposite, and it's really, really sad, and I love that about it. They just broke away from the stigma, and it was very good. This movie suffers from a really bad villain. The Red Skull was horrible. I could not stand that guy. Who was he? Like, he just showed up once or twice, and he looked evil. He did some evil things, but I didn't know what he was doing overall, so I didn't care about him. And just the entire Hydra, I think it was introduced okay, but it was overall it's a bad concept. I don't like the concept, but it was introduced fine. This movie gets a 3 out of 5. The last movie, the greatest of the first phase, obviously, everyone can agree on this. This is gonna be the greatest. This is Avengers, the first Avengers. I don't know what it's about. It's just a great, fun movie with all the heroes coming together. It's just brilliant. I love it. It's got a great, great concept of an entire arc for each of these characters. I loved the fact that they were coming together to fight against this evil together. I love the playing between the characters. I love the dialogue. I loved everything to do with these characters in this movie. That just blew it away from me. The problem I have with this movie is the villains, which was really, really annoying because just thinking back to it, I can't imagine who was the villain. I know Loki was the villain, and there were some alien dudes, but that's all I can remember. I don't know why Loki was talking to the aliens. It's so forgettable that I can't even, like, stick with it. Those are just really bad villains. But the characters coming together, I really enjoyed the fight scenes up until the very, very end, which kind of got very forgettable to me because stuff was just going down that didn't have a strong emotional aspect of it and didn't have a strong physical aspect of it. Stuff just went down that just concluded it. There was one part that was really great at the very end, but that's, you know, one part apart from the main end of the climax, which is unfortunate. But overall, this entire movie comes together to create great characters, great plot, great everything to do with the entire franchise. It does a really great justice for all these characters and for this entire franchise. I really love this movie, but I can't give it a perfect just because of the villain problem, which was really annoying for me because it was a great concept for a villain. It just failed miserably. So I'm just gonna go ahead and give this a 4 out of 5, greatest of this entire phase, but it's not really that great overall. It's a solid movie. It does well for what it's given, but a 4 out of 5 is all I'm gonna give it. Just the villains really irked me. So to finish this off, I'm gonna go ahead and rank all the movies, and of course I'm gonna start off with Avengers being one of the greatest movies of this entire phase, one of the greatest movies of the entire MCU, obviously. Everybody agrees with that, but I don't put it as high up. It's pretty solid, but it's not at the top for me. That goes at the beginning. Then we go ahead with probably the second Iron Man. I enjoyed that. I don't know if I rated that higher or lower than Captain America. I might have rated it lower, but in personal taste, I enjoyed that a lot more, even though I know it has a lot of problems. Third, I give it to a Captain America, which was a fairly good movie for the first hour, and the second hour kind of got weird and really forgettable, so I'm gonna cancel that out there. Then I'm gonna pull up the first Iron Man because it had such a simplistic tale that was done fairly well enough that I enjoyed it. It was okay, it didn't do that great, but it was cool enough for me because everything after this was kind of meh or bad meh. So then we go ahead right to Hulk, which was bad meh. It was really hurt to watch. It was really boring at times. Its tone was just weird and I didn't like it. I didn't like the entire movie coming together as a whole. The individual parts, like the plot, was pretty solid. Character itself was pretty solid, but coming together, it was just had a really bad flow that I didn't enjoy. Then finally, at the sixth place of this entire phase, I give it to Thor because it is really bad. Everyone agrees. The entire concept is really bad. The only thing good was Thor's arc and Thor's character, which was okay at the beginning and middle and end, all of it. Thor was just a great character, but he had really bad position to play in this because everything was really bad except for Thor's bubble of what he was kind of facing with his father and his brother. That was kind of interesting, and that was executed okay until the end, but everything else was really badly executed. So that's going to be my entire phase one review. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please slap a like down below, and please comment. Tell me what you think of my ranking. Tell me what you think of your ranking. Let me know what you thought of any of these movies and any of the other stuff. This video is getting long, so I'm going to go ahead and end this really quick. I'll be putting out a phase two videos pretty fairly kind of soon, so look out for that, and I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye!